Hello and welcome to the first of our introductory videos to swing dance from the University of Sheffield Swing Dance Society. In this video, I'm going to be showing the basic steps of Lindy Hop in both the 8 and 6 count variations. And I'll be showing the footwork for both the lead and the follow, and how they work together. First, I'm going to go over a bit of history of where it comes from, and then I'll get into showing you the dance. So what's first most important is to remember when we're talking about swing dancing, we're not necessarily talking about Lindy Hop, and the titles aren't necessarily synonymous. So Lindy Hop is a style of swing dancing, but swing dancing on the whole comes from basically any dance that is to music that is swung, so swing music. Mm-hmm. And that encompasses a range of different dances such as Balboa, Lindy Charleston, Lindy Hop, obviously, Shag, Collegiate Shag. That's quite an important distinction to remember when talking about swing dancing. It's not necessarily Lindy Hop. So Lindy Hop itself originated in Harlem in the late 1920s and early 1930s, and it was actually seen as a huge cultural phenomenon at the time, because it was one of the very first kind of entertainment activities that started to break down the racial barriers, particularly in America. The way a lot of Lindy Hop came about was black entertainers would see the kind of structured dances that were seen as very, very white at the time, and basically not necessarily mocked them, but took them and evolved it to be more relaxed and more enjoyable and more fun. So it took a lot of inspiration from kind of like 20s Charleston, early 20s Charleston, tap dancing. The foxtrot is said to be a very early influence. And the cakewalk as well, which is another pre-Civil War, really, American-African dance. And so it was mainly the merger of those rhythmic African dances and African rhythms mixed with these European, structured, very uptight dances. And the mixture of those created, Lindy Hop as we know it today. And so it gained a lot of popularity during those times when black entertainers would start dancing these dances and entertaining others with them, and the white community ironically would actually start to learn and try and pick up and emulate these dances without actually realizing that they were kind of a mockery of the very structured dance formats of the white Western world. And so in doing so, the dance gained more and more popularity, and then eventually in the as big band music became more and more popular, and jazz music was obviously the all the rage at the time, it fueled the dancing or craze, as it is, into really coming alive, and so that, coupled with obviously the white community getting more enthralled by it, really, really picked it up and picked it off. And then it began to fade out of popularity, mainly with the music fading out of popularity, because it is a dance based off the music after all, swing dancing. So when in the late 40s and early 50s, when kind of bebop and rock and roll music came along, the swing dancing in the traditional sense kind of started to fade away. But it's an incredibly important cultural phenomenon at the time, and what was even more interesting actually was, well, not necessarily more interesting, but as well as breaking down the racial barriers, there were also very few gendered roles, or no real gendered roles scene in Lindy Hop. Traditionally, with kind of European structured dances, there's a lot more say in terms of the man or the gentleman would be the lead and the female or the woman would be the follow. Where in Lindy Hop, that's never really been a thing. Even when it was kind of coming about, a lot of the time it was all just complete mixed and matched, especially during kind of the late 30s and early 40s, when big band was still quite big, but obviously the world was actually at war, which meant that finding a male dance partner was a lot harder than it is today or beforehand. So it was very, very common for, you know, women to lead or men to follow. And so not only has the dance broken down kind of cultural barriers of race at the time, but also actually the gender roles within dancing have been completely changed by kind of Lindy Hop and swing dancing. And so that's a rough overview of how we know it today. There's a lot more to it, and if you're interested, I highly recommend going and Googling more. But that's all I shall say for now, and I will now see you in my living room and show you the basic of the 6-count and 8-count Lindy Hop. Okay, so here I am in my living room. I'm going to show you the basic for both lead and follow Lindy Hop in both 6-count and 8-count, and they're very similar. They both hinge on the same two types of footwork, and once you get that footwork, it's pretty much the exact same for 99% of all Lindy Hop. So once you've got the basic, then you can get dancing. I'm going to start by showing you 8-count. I'm going to start with showing the leads footwork, as that's what I started with, and then I'll move on to the follow footwork and show you that with some music. So the first bit of footwork is called a rock step, and that's very simple. It's the first two counts, and you're simply just going rock step. So if I'll do that from the side as well, you see with the lead is starting on the left leg, and so you're going rock step, and you'll notice from there your weight will be on your right and your left will be free. So once you've got that down, you'll then want to know the second step, which is the triple step, and that leads directly, that comes directly from the rock step straight afterwards. So if you rock step, you go rock step, you'll notice that your weight, as said, is on the right, and this is free. So with your left foot, you're now going to bring that forward and triple step. So you're going to go one, two, three. Just do that again for you so you see. So for the triple step, three small steps of triple step. So when you put that together, it should look like this. You're going rock, step, triple step. Now you'll notice that when you finish, your weight is on the left leg and your right leg is suspended. And that's perfect because that leads on to the next count, which is another rock step. So once you go rock, step, triple step, you're then going rock, step, and then once you've got that down, you're then triple stepping back and going triple step. It's a bit trickier to see when you're going backwards, but it's the exact same motion, rock, step, triple step. And then your weight is on your right again. And once you get the hang of that, you can do the entire thing in a loop, like so. So you can go rock, step, triple step, rock, step, triple step. Do that once more, face on, so you can see that. Just rock, step, triple step, rock, step, triple step. So that's the 8-count footwork.
and you can see it's eight count, because if I do it again, you can count out the beats of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So you have 8 beats in total. So that's the 8 count basic. For the follow, it's the exact same footwork, you're just doing it on the other foot. So you're starting your rock step on your right foot. And so instead of rock stepping back with your left, you're just doing it with your right, and then following through with the same footwork but just reversed. So you're going rock, step, triple step, rock, step, triple step, rock, step, triple step, rock, step, triple step. But this time you're using your right foot to start the rocks, well, the triple step, and you're rock stepping back on your right as opposed to your left, which is the lead, obviously. Now for six count, it is very, very similar, except you're taking away two of the counts, obviously, because you're going from 8 to 6. And so that count is the second rock step you're taking away. So as opposed to the count looking like this, or the basic looking like this for the lead, I'm gonna demonstrate. Instead of going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, you're simply just gonna do 6 instead. So you're going rock, step, triple step. And here's where the difference is. As opposed to rock stepping again, you're just triple stepping back. And then you're just starting the entire process again. So you're just going rock, step, triple step, triple step. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And so on and so forth. And yet again, it's the exact same for the follow. You're just starting on your right instead. And you're going rock, step, triple step, triple step, rock, step, triple step, triple step. And that's the six count basic. It is, as you can see, very, very similar. When you're actually on the dance floor, you can switch them up quite a bit. It doesn't really matter too much. But for a beginner, it's a bit easier to just stick to one or two. Eight or six, and just pick one. I usually go for 8 because it's a bit more simple, gives you a bit more time. But yeah, once you get that basic down, you can really do 90% of all the moves in Lindy Hop. Now, it is a partnered dance, of course, so when I've been doing it, obviously solo due to quarantine, I can't show you that, but when you have a partner, one of you can learn to lead and the other one learns to follow, and you can do it together and dance together and learn all those kind of other fantastic moves. But that's the basic step for Lindy Hop. And so I'm gonna put some music on and just demonstrate kind of the timings that you can do with it. And yeah, feel free to rewatch the video and get the hang of it.
You got but I won't just sing this song. Since my baby's been gone, everything is lost. I'm on the stick, and I can't get off. One scotch, one bourbon, one beer. One scotch, one bourbon.
And there you have it. That is the basic 6 and 8 count for both the lead and the follow. That's all there is to it. Thank you very much for watching. This has been the first of hopefully many tutorial videos from the University of Sheffield Swing Society, and we hope to see you dancing soon.